the Maldives, lying approximately 450 miles off the southern coast of Sri Lanka and surrounded by nothing but the warm Indian Ocean. Just under 1,200 islands make up this, the lowest of all the countries in the world. Famous for its natural beauty, abundant and colourful sea life, and of course for being the number one destination for the ultimate romantic honeymoon. For the next hour, we will show you the accommodation, the cuisine, in fact, everything these islands have to offer. So sit back and relax as we focus on the Maldives. The Maldives are made up of 23 different atolls and 1,192 islands. In this program, we will put the spotlight on just two, the resort islands of Coco Palm Botahiti and Coco Palm Dunikolu, collectively known as the Coco Collection.
My name is Hussein Hilmi. I'm a director of Coco Collection. Under Coco Collection at the moment, we have got Coco Palm Botahiti and Coco Palm Dunikolu. We began our business in a very small way. About 25 years ago when my brother started the company as a travel agency, initially just providing meat and veggie services at the airport. We developed our first five-star resort, that's Coco Palm Dunikolu, in 1998. And that has been a huge success. So with that success, it was quite natural for us to develop our second five-star property, that's the Coco Palm Botahiti. And that's how we began our luxury brand, the Coco Collection. Dunikolu is the only resort in the southern part of Bar Atoll. And our nearest neighbors are two inhabited islands and of course a large number of uninhabited islands. So really, Dunikolu is like in a world of its own. For the guests who come to our resort, it's a very quiet and a very, very special location to spend their holiday.
Well, I'm Philippe Ruger. Actually, I'm the general manager of the Dunikolu Resort and Spa. Dunikolu is a bit special. We are in a wild environment, but with all the comfort. We've got all the accommodation with all the facilities. Food and beverage is very important. Environment is very important. And the main program for us is just having a rest.
120 kilometers away in Male Atoll lies the resort of Coco Palm Botahiti.
Botahiti being located in Male Atoll, but nevertheless, it's not too close to the airport. So it's not in a very busy area, but at the same time, not too far away so that it's easy for people coming to the Maldives to get to the island.
Hi, my name's Mario Stenik and I'm the general manager of the hotel. I think Coco Palm Botahiti is a unique product and it has a Maldivian feeling, different to some of the international hotels we have here. It's very casual, it's very relaxed, but at the same time the service and the amenities are five-star. I think we have some great rooms. Our rooms are beautiful, very romantic. The facilities are wonderful, and everything we do at this resort is centered around honeymooners and centered around being together.
Both are extremely good quality resorts. Dunikolu is more natural in its total development concept. A bit more rustic in style, but at the same time, it's very much encompasses the overall philosophy of providing a high degree of service and quality of accommodation and food. Whereas Botahiti is more contemporary and more chic in its outlook. The islands are very, very beautiful. It's an opportunity to interact with nature, the harmony, the quietness, the beauty, and even in a typical resort which might have about 50 or 100 rooms, you would really feel as if you're on your own on the island. So the privacy and the beauty, the stunning beauty of the place is what really, I think, attracts people to come to the Maldives.
You know, the guest at the end of the day is the number one person on the island. Of course, that's why we're all here. Our goal, my goal, is to give them an experience from the day they arrive to the day they leave. Anything the guests want, they can order. We can order you a plane to do a photo shoot in a plane, go around the island. We can order you a yacht to go out sailing. We have island hopping trips, fishing trips. We have snorkeling trips. We have half-day snorkeling trips. We have diving, of course. Every Wednesday night, we have a cinema under the stars, which is a wonderful experience. So, yeah, I think there's something for everybody. And I think that a honeymoon couple would have a wonderful time here.
Whether you spend your honeymoon on Bodahiti or Dunikolu, as soon as you get here, you will feel like the most important person in the world. A speedboat transfer from the airport will take you straight to Bodahiti. Or for a truly magical experience, a 30-minute seaplane journey. And then a short ride by Dhoni will take you to Dunikolu, where a special welcome awaits.
We've got a special trio. I can't say special because they are here since a long time.
Welcome to Popo Pamal's Island in the sun. Enjoy your holidays, friends, this land will be fun. Round and round the Popo Pam, please sing in the breeze.
The welcome song from Coco Palm has been written by Victor, which is a team leader of the trio, and this is the leitmotif. This is something which is a part of the welcoming and of the special welcoming of Dunikolu, Coco Palm. The drink is a welcome drink. We call that kurumba in Maldives. This is a fresh coconut, a young coconut, which is offered to the guest with some flowers and a straw, of course. We are welcoming everyone on the same level because for me, everybody is special. All our guests are special, very special, because in the hotelery business, you should please everyone. So giving a service with quality, this is very important.
Thank you. You are welcome. Welcome to Coco Palm.
Still to come, we show you how you can have your marriage blessed in a traditional Maldivian ceremony. And we take a peek inside the stunning accommodation of Bodahiti. So you've arrived in the Maldives for your honeymoon. What better way to celebrate than by having your wedding blessed in a traditional Maldivian ceremony?
Well, we have a wonderful wedding process here, and the wedding process is done on a sandbank, which is in the middle of the ocean, and of course it's nothing on the sandbank, no trees, no buildings, and that's quite romantic. We give the bride a traditional outfit, the groom has a white sarong, and then you are taken by Dhoni, which is decorated, out to the sandbank. While you're going out there, the whole Dhoni is decorated, and on the Dhoni you have some Maldivian staff playing traditional bodabaru, which is the drums, and that's very unique to the Maldives, of course. And then when you get out there, the groom and the staff will be waiting a little pergola, which is made out of thatched palm leaves. and then they would escort the bride up to the groom. There they would exchange floral wreaths in front of all the guests. When we do the weddings, one staff would read from the Quran, some passages about your wedding, of course. And then sometimes there's someone translating the passages into English, if you wish.
Marriage is the full and free consent of man and woman's legitimate means to the preservation of mankind, and it is a must that two parties involved in this marriage to respect this philosophy. May God bless this marriage and make you a happy couple. You may exchange the rings now.
At the end of the ceremony, there is a karumba, which is what they call a coconut drink, and this karumba is passed around as part of the Maldivian ceremony. And that's a traditional thing, so that's very nice. And then when you come back, on the boat again, and the Bodabru is playing, and everyone is singing and clapping. And then when you get back to the hotel, there's a gentleman with a little umbrella, which is a traditional thing in the Maldives, and they throw flowers on your head as you walk into the resort, which is a lovely thing. And then, part of the package is that we give you a little coconut palm, and you get to plant that. And then in front of that, we put a little plaque and it says your name and what day you were married. And then we put a bit of water on that, and that tree stays there and that plaque stays there forever. And many, many guests actually come back to the resort to see their tree, or actually many guests also call the resort and say, can you take a picture of my tree and send it to me? That's the end of the ceremony. So it's very romantic, and it's very, very popular at the resort.
The natural beauty of the Maldives is spectacular. So it's not surprising the accommodation is too. From infinity pools that stretch to the horizon and beyond, to gorgeous interiors. Whatever you're looking for your honeymoon, Bodahiti will have it.
Well, you know, we have 100 rooms here. Four different categories. One is an island villa, a water villa, an escape water villa, and an escape water residency, which is our top category. The residency is great. The residency, as I said, is our exclusive rooms. In this area, we've just introduced our new Club Coco benefits. A few of the benefits, there's about 40 of them. We have a buggy, we have 24-hour butler service, 24-hour room service. You have a private restaurant, a private lounge, a private bar. These are some of the things that are part of the benefits. Your butler, if you're a residency guest, your butler will go to the airport, will pick you up at the airport, bring you back to the residency. As soon as you get to the hotel, unlike other guests, you will be escorted directly to your room. When you get to your room, there'll be a butler that would wait for you with a glass of French champagne to welcome you into your room.
Welcome home. So please.
Your butler would then explain the room to you.
This is your bedroom. From here, you will get the best view from the island. this beautiful reef until end is really beautiful.
Of course, you have a very large balcony with a day bed outside and a dining table, which leads directly into your into the ocean.
The lower deck, which you will have the view of the coral garden.
And on the right, you have a large pool, like all of our villas. So it's a very, very nice room, and the service is great there, and we have a great team of butlers. And I'm happy to say that most of our butlers are Maldivians, so that's a great touch as well. An escape water villa is directly over water. It has a bathtub which looks into the water, a big king-size bed which looks out over glass windows onto your large balcony, and then there's a very big plunge pool. And off that there's a day bed which leads directly into the water, and at the back of the bathroom you have an outdoor shower. It's a very nice room. Island villa is lovely. When you enter the door, it has a beautiful round bathtub in the centre. Just above that is a nice chandelier. And that has little blue lights at night that light up. It's very, very romantic. So on one side, you have the ocean. That leads directly onto your beach. On the other side, you have your swimming pool. When you go into the lounge room, you go down split-level stairs into a sunken lounge room. And then you go onto your balcony, where you have two lounges, and then you have a dining table and another day bed outside under a big palm tree, which is very nice. And at the back, there's a very nice little garden and a beautiful outdoor shower. A great room, very romantic, and one of our most popular rooms.
After a relaxing night's sleep, what better way to reinvigorate yourself than with a sunrise yoga session? All skills levels are covered. Beginners wanting to learn more about this ancient art form are particularly welcomed.
My name is Lijoy Raj. I'm from India. I'm from International Shivananda Yoga Vedanta Center. It's an international organization giving teachers training courses in yoga.
Palms facing up, you can breathe into your abdomen, you can relax the abdominal muscle. Gently, you can bring the feet together.
The sessions that we are doing here is taken from the topmost yoga research center in India, VK Yogas in Bangalore. And in the morning, we are having some sessions like group sessions, which consist of sunrise yoga, in which we'll be giving slight stretching forms, breathing techniques, and relaxing forms. We are giving an introductory session in yoga, and that is a yoga initiation, which is given to the guest who is not knowing about yoga, for introducing what is yoga, what is in yoga, how yoga will be beneficial for you, how yoga will relieve stress from you.
Yoga isn't just about learning to relax. It can enhance all areas of life.
If you have got any problem in your managerial level, in your educational level, psychological level, spiritual level, therapeutic level, we can apply yoga for finding the solution for that. Usually the guest believes that it can be done only through those people who are having high flexibility, high perfection and all. Because in yoga, perfection and flexibility is not a factor. Okay? That will come only with the regular practice.
With such a stunning backdrop, sunrise yoga is the perfect way to start the day. With more than 9 different restaurants on the 2 resorts offering buffets, a la carte dining, and private meals for 2, you'll be spoiled for choice. Watch breakfast or lunch cooked in front of your very eyes. And for dinner, why not try some of the amazing seafood on offer?
The food we serve here is really encompasses all the flavors from the region. We use the local seafood, the reef fish that is caught fresh daily. We use fruits from throughout the Asia Pacific region. Vegetables are flown in from Europe. So all food is really from all over the world. We've got a multinational workforce here really, and we love doing what we do. We prepare the food as fresh as possible. We love using fresh ingredients, and we don't want to stifle one another's creativity. We've all got a little bit to bring to the different styles of food we serve at Borehiti.
So let's start with breakfast. Served as a buffet, you'll find all your favorite dishes. Fresh fruit. And for the more adventurous palate, a selection of regional delicacies. Or for that honeymoon treat, how about a private champagne breakfast served in your own villa?
If people want to have breakfast in their villas or in their escape water residences, that can be arranged through in-villa service. So really, people can have a romantic breakfast for two well away from a restaurant if they so wish or so desire.
Over on Dunikolu at lunchtime, you can watch fresh food prepared right in front of you.
Over here in the live cooking, we have three sections. One is with the wok. It consists of Asian specialties. It's all-time favorites. And another one is the grill. It's basically like our local fishes. And then the other one is the pan-fried items, and also based on our also specialties of the day. We use the finest ingredients and spices as well. And also we homegrown our own vegetables and also some of the spices as well. It's very fresh. Yes, it's very, very good. All our guests are very happy, regardless of which country they are from, especially like in France or in Italy or Germany or in English. They like our live cooking very, very much.
And finally, if you've room left, you can sample the best the sea has to offer with a fantastic beach barbecue.
We try to stay away from the basic burger sausage scenario. We try to serve local lobster. We're trying to serve local reef fish, prawn, you know, different items than different style of sambos that we would have in this part of the world. There's live music. You know, can dance in the sand if they would so desire, and basically it's all the styles of food we serve here in a barbecue setting, or they can, if they so desire, they can book a barbecue, more romantic, a barbecue for two at different locations throughout the property.
It's one thing to eat all this delicious seafood, but it's quite another to catch it. Every night, skilled fishermen take to the waters to reel in that scrumptious catch. And if you want to, why not join them? With those well-trained eyes, they can spot the faintest of fish movements. Even if it's not on the menu. When they are far enough out to sea, they drop anchor, bait the lines, and like generations before them, they play the waiting game.
We have got a weight at the end of the line, so we choose a spot and drop the line. Once the weight hits the bottom, we lift it off from the bottom, then hold the line till the fish starts biting. From the time, you know, when the earliest settlers came to the Maldives, which is during the 5th century BC, as a long, long time back. So from then onwards, you know, the lifestyle of the Maldivian has always been fishing. So just from 5th century BC onwards till now. Fishing depends in the Maldives, depends on, like, you know, the season and the place and the tide and the lunar calendar, you know, it depends on a lot of things. But on a good night, you'll be able to get a lot of fish. A lot of fish.
One. Yeah.
That's what we call fishing. There you go.
Hey, you got it?
Of course.
Oh, finally, after interview, no, you got it. Great man.
Continuing long after sunset, these fishermen are sure to bring home a great haul.
That was fantastic. You got a red snapper, you got a green job fish, and you got humpback snappers. You're gonna have it for dinner.
If all this talk of food has your mouth watering, then you could always take part in a cooking class on Bodahiti.
A couple can join us and just actually get their head around some of the different kind of sambals and spices and flavorings we're using. It's not really a daunting task. We'd walk you through some basic preparation and certainly have those items for lunch.
And what better way to wash it down than with fine wine and champagne tasting in Bodahiti's extensive wine cellar, hosted by the food and beverage manager.
Hello, how are you today? We are going in the cellar.
So a very good choice for this lovely champagne.
Still to come, we'll transport you off under the Indian Ocean and join a sunrise dolphin watching trip.
As far as our resorts are concerned, what makes them unique is the fact that we are trying to provide not only a boutique style or contemporary design. But we are also trying to provide a real touch of the Maldivian experience, the traditions, the history, the culture, and the soul of the country, if I may put it that way. We are providing opportunities for our guests to interact with the people of the country and also to experience their way of life. We provide opportunities for people to go out with a local fisherman on a typical day's fishing trip. Likewise, an opportunity to stay with a local family on an island. So we are trying to provide opportunities for the guests to try out new experiences, not only enjoy the beach, the sun and the sand and the water, which of course is quite inviting and very popular, yes. But at the same time, we would also like to provide opportunities for people to really get a glimpse of the history and the culture of the people of Maldives.
It's not just the local culture that's of importance to the Coco collection. Maintaining and preserving the country's wildlife is too.
It's very important for us to maintain the islands in its natural environment as much as we can. When we built Dunikolo as a resort, we came to realize that it has been a breeding ground for turtles. So we made sure that the intensity of lights that we put up on the island were quite low, especially on the vegetation line near the beach, so that it will not disturb the turtles who come frequently for breeding on the island.
Dunikolu's lush vegetation gives the island a real rustic and natural feel. Conserving this is something very important in the development of the resort.
The construction itself, we make sure that we give a lot of consideration to conserve the natural beauty of the island. So we have got only low-line constructions using natural materials. No buildings are above coconut tree tops, and to ensure that the greenery is very much encompassing the buildings to make sure that it's quite blending with the total natural landscape of the island. So these are the kind of things that we undertake on the island to make sure that our overall operational philosophy does match the development concept of the island.
The resort of Dunikolu has a more relaxed and rustic feel, and the accommodation reflects that. Made from natural material, here you feel like you're at one with nature. General Manager Philippe Fruguer showcases the honeymoon suite.
Well, we are in this wonderful suite in Coco Palm Dunikolu. This resort got two suites for honeymooners as well, with this nice plunge pool. We've got one plunge pool in every suite, which has the best one with the best view on the sea around a few islands, Virgin Islands. And normally people are very happy about that. Shall we go inside? This is the main living room made from natural items, natural wood. The roofing is made exclusively from coconuts, and the superficie is quite big. Facilities with a mini bar, library, a nice desk also. This wonderful welcoming is a part of the package for honeymooners. And so we got in every room a nice fruit basket and some champagne and some flower decoration for the pleasure of everybody. Decoration is very important for Coco Palm Dunikolu, and you can see that we can do nice honeymoon decoration. The bed is something exceptional, and we try to do things, simple things, but nice things to please our guests and repeaters who come and come back again for the same concept. So this bathroom is made with all the facilities. As you can see, we've got a nice jacuzzi. The view is exclusive on the sea with this nice blue Indian Ocean sea. Well, as I talk to you about the suite and the nice setting in the suite, I have to talk to you about the structure of this wonderful water villa. As a matter of fact, the structure is designed as a leaf. This was the first concept done like this 11 years ago. Since 11 years ago, other people designed similar kind of concept, but this one has been the first one, as a matter of fact. So we are developing this nice honeymoon concept, and we are welcome to receive all your UK guests at Coco Palm Dunikolu. Thank you.
Another option nestled in amongst the foliage is the exquisite deluxe beach villa. With nature encompassing both sides, it has a real ecological feel.
Also, the inside of it is mainly focused on ecosystem. We are not gold and silver, but we are nicely furnished with some wooden design, focus on the history of the Maldives, focus on the basic artisanal work of local people, of course, international design as well, with all the facilities. The material around the beds are nicely arranged. And we've got 57 beach villas on the island, which are located on the main island. On top of that, you have some water villas, which we call lagoon villas, which are on the water. and we've got 12 of them, offering a wonderful view and possibility to be again more and more exclusive and isolated. Lagoon villas are a little bit bigger. The ceilings are higher, but basically this is again coconut wood, some kinds of furniture on the same style, but arranged differently. The terraces are very nice and you can have the possibility to go directly to have a nice swim in the lagoon, which is also something very unique.
Unique is a perfect way to describe the lagoons surrounding the resorts. A veritable feast of diverse and wonderful wildlife lies just below the surface. The coral reefs of the Maldives have one of the densest fish populations in the world. From all manner of sharks, to the elegant and majestic rays. Plunging under the water will seem like you've entered another world. This is all made easy by Dive Ocean, located on both resorts. Whether you're an absolute beginner or a seasoned pro, there are excursions to suit all levels. Base leader Andrea explains just one of the many on offer.
So my name is Andrea. I'm the base leader of Dive Ocean in Kokopan. And I'm as well as an instructor. Divers or non-divers are very welcome here because the house reef is very simple but very beautiful, so it's good for beginners and it's good for advanced because we have different levels where we have the reef starting. So if you want to do your first step, you will have a brief view of the skills you are doing later on in the lagoon in a depth of 1.5 meters. Then you descend on a rope to a sandy pass to 4 or 5 meters. After adaptation, you are able to do a dive to a maximum depth of 12 meters, of course, together with an instructor.
Such wondrous sights are sure to take your breath away, but Andrea has a word of advice.
I'm always telling the guest, you have to breathe here on land, so the same you have to do underwater. So the reaction of the people is they are going to say, it's beautiful, it's great, fantastic experience. I would say to anyone that you find the perfect conditions to learn diving or to continue diving here in Kokopan.
After spending a couple of hours exploring the sea, what better way to adjust to dry land than by relaxing at one of Coco Palm's health spas? Bodahiti's health spa offers all the modern facilities, a gym, saunas, and treatment rooms. It's the ideal setting to truly relax. The gentle sound of the sea beneath you, combined with the fragrant aromas of fresh flowers and exotic spices, will all help your mind and body completely rejuvenate. Over on Dunikolu, in keeping with the island's rustic theme, you can have a number of treatments on the beach. Let yourself be pampered by the skilled hands of the staff. A visit to the health spas of Coco Palms is the perfect way to indulge. There are a variety of different excursions you can choose while staying in the Maldives. Dunikolu's guest relations officer explains one of the most popular.
My name is Anas. I'm a guest relation officer. And my role is over here is taking care of all of the excursions we do over here, which is perfect for me. I love the excursion, that part. That's really nice. We go dolphin watching at 7:30 early in the morning with sunrise. We go out about 20 minutes away from here, and we're looking for mostly like spinner dolphins and bottle dolphins. And it's the most, I would say, common excursions we have on a Cuckoo Palm.
The waters around Dunikolu have the largest population of dolphins, so spotting them should be easy.
Most of the guests there, they're really happy to see dolphins in the wild, because in Maldives, we don't do dolphin training and we don't have anything like that. So in the wild, they're perfect to see. It's amazed me also every day, because I go every day to see the dolphins, but each and every day, I love to see them spinning around. Because if you see them, it really touches you. It's something you won't forget. And if once you go, you like to go twice, and more than that. That's something you won't forget in your life.
Still to come, you'll see how you can enjoy the most romantic time together by luxuriating on your own private island. So far, we've taken you underwater to see the dolphins, pampered you with sensuous massages on the beach, and now you're probably thinking you've seen all the Maldives has to offer. Well, that couldn't be further from the truth. The tiny island of Mbudu is a 10-minute boat journey away from Dunikolu. And if you want the ultimate romantic experience, then book a private overnight stay for you and your partner.
Well, I believe this island is a little bit special because authentic. When you come to Maldives, do you want to have something who is a reflection of what you can find in Europe? I don't think so. A special room is built over there, which is a little bit more rustic, but again, with all the convenient furniture and accommodation. And we can organize something very special, like a picnic during the day, like a barbecue in the night. But I believe we try our best to do the best for our guests, actually.
Two current guests are English couple Rob and Nick. They have just spent the day on Robinson Crusoe Island and are more than happy to share their experience.
It started amazing because literally we went for a walk straight away and then sure we saw dolphins. First thing we saw. It's just, can't really beat that. You arrive and you don't really know what to expect.
Oh, wow.
What do you think, huh?
Beautiful.
But there's a beautiful, beautiful classic traditional hut that you can go into and chill out in.
How's that?
Gorgeous. Even though you're completely on your own island, you've still got a bit of luxury. You have a shower, toilet,
still
bed,
I'm still imagining towels. Castaway and Tom Hanks and thinking how I can do it.
Yeah.
I'm not sure. Never going to succeed. I need the luxuries. You're the only ones on this island, and you sort of do an exploration thinking you can't be the only ones on. You are.
Although it's a tiny island, there's a lot to do. We've snorkeled around the whole island. We've slept, we've sunbathed, we've read, we've walked around. We've seen a lot.
That's beautiful.
Absolutely beautiful. It's been just the best day of our whole honeymoon, just absolutely beautiful. It's really made it, hasn't it? Gorgeous.
Yeah, it's a gorgeous place. And the picnic was pretty amazing.
Yeah. The food's been absolutely beautiful as well. Yeah. Everything, can't fault a thing.
You
do feel a bit of a celebrity.
You do feel a bit of a celebrity. You do feel a bit pampered, to be fair. Yeah.
That's been perfect, absolutely beyond our dreams, I think, for a honeymoon. And especially this island as well, just to be on your own, and it's very romantic and beautiful.
Over the last hour, we've shown you everything the Maldives has to offer to make your honeymoon the most romantic and unforgettable experience of your life. All thanks to the Coco Collection.
What drives us to do this is a passion for what we are doing, obviously, and it's always very important for us to deliver our promises and live up to the expectations that we are creating. So this is the challenge, and it's very satisfying to see that happen. And we are able to compete with the international brands in the Maldives with our own unique creations. So this is something that's extremely satisfying. So what I would say is, you know, make use of this opportunity. Don't wait. This is the time to come and visit the Maldives. Thank you.
The Maldives might seem a world away, but you can fly there easily with Emirates, Qatar Airways, Sri Lankan Airlines, and now British Airways. Coco Palms sincerely wishes you a happy holiday.